Hey everyone and welcome back! Today we're gonna create a very realistic drawing of a bird. This is going to look highly professional, so if you want to take your digital drawing skill to the next level, make sure to watch this tutorial till the end. I promise this is easier to recreate than you might be thinking, and as usual I'll share with you all my tips and tricks along the process. The canvas size I'm using is 3000 by 4000 pixels at 300 dpi, and the colored profile is RGB. Now, let's begin by making the background black. On the first layer, I'll start drawing the head of the bird using the Studio Pen brush. First, I'm creating this small oval shape, and I continue by drawing a long, curvy neck. As always, use the transform tool if you need to move your layer around, resize it, or modify it in any way. Then, I'll create a new layer on top of the first one and start drawing the body. Don't worry about making it perfect for the first try. I'd say constructing the perfect shape is a process. That's the beauty of digital drawing. You can move things around, reshape, and resize them. Now I'm preparing to draw the legs. Make a new layer and draw the upper part of the front leg. Please take care and place the layer under the body. Then do the same for the other leg, placing the layer under the previous one. I keep nagging you about the layers order because this is really important later in the process when we'll do the shading. But of course, if you make any mistakes, you can always rearrange the layers. If you're a beginner or just a more organized person than I am, I suggest you to rename the layers because they kind of look the same on the layer list. I am changing the white for a brown color and create more layers for the rest of the legs. I'm following the same logic as I did earlier, placing them under the previous layers. Now I'll make one last layer on top of everything to add the beak and the eye of the bird. I'm drawing as slowly as possible because I want you to understand everything that I'm doing, but normally this would go so much faster. After I draw the general shape, I'm using the eraser to perfect it a little bit. Unfortunately, the camera stopped working for a minute and it was just as I did that. At this point, the drawing is done and we need to alpha lock the layers in order to start shading and adding the details. Swipe two fingers to the right on the layer name to turn on the alpha lock, or just tap the layer and select the option. To add a little bit of texture and volume, I'm using one of my own brushes called the Cotton Pepper. I keep saying these brushes will be available really soon. I'm so proud of them and can't wait to share them with you guys. Anyway, the most important part of this drawing will be done with a regular Procreate brush that you absolutely have. And I'm pretty sure you never thought about using it this way. Using light blue and gray, I'm starting to slowly build up some volume. Please take a look on the color stickers to know the exact color I'm using each time. Also, with Procreate, you can see the brush size and opacity on those brush bars on the left side of my iPad screen. The keyword for creating a realistic drawing or illustration is always patience. The more time you'll spend on the drawing, the better it will look. Try to work with gentle little strokes and build up the volume slowly. As a general rule, I strongly suggest you to have some good reference photos when doing realistic art. You can take them yourselves or find them online. For this illustration, I'm using an amazing photo that I found on unsplash.com. I link it in the video description. If you have opened that photo, you have probably noticed that I'm not using those exact colors. I'm mainly using my reference image to understand the shapes and the bird anatomy. When I'm done with the head and neck, I'll follow the same process for all the parts covered in feathers. Thank you. While drawing, I keep using the same shortcuts for selecting a layer or a color. If you've been watching my tutorials for a while, you probably know them by now, but if you're new on the channel, welcome, by the way, I want you to press that key icon near the gallery, then press gesture controls, and take a good look on how you can customize those options. I promise it will change the whole Procreate experience for you. The most important for me are the touch option for the layer select and the touch and hold for the eyedropper to pick a color from the screen. Back to the drawing, we want to add some details to the beak. Some of you might say this is the hard part. Well, I think this is the fun part really. Start by adding a soft black shadow on the tip of the beak and then some light green and orange lighting on the tip and in the eye area. The real art here is to be able to combine different colors in order to achieve a realistic yet pictorial effect. To create the details, we're gonna decrease the texture brush size and use it as a pencil brush to draw with it. Most of my brushes will give you different effects depending on their size and opacity. I love a good adaptable brush. Back in the art school, we kept hearing this aphorism saying that a good artist is able to paint a complete canvas using a single brush. Now that I'm more experienced, I'd say this is absolutely true, but then it also depends on how good that brush is. What do you think about that? Do you agree? For the eye, I'm sketching two circles centered by a big dot. Then, I'll be using brown and black and draw some tiny lines on the beak. Can you see the way I'm overlapping small strokes when creating those lines? Working like this, I can't make any mistakes since there are no harsh lines. I'm building up those details, just as I did with the volume. If there's something I'd really want you to remember from my videos, that would be to always build up when drawing. The perfect shape or line, color, composition, you'll find them all in the process if you have the patience to overlap. A good exercise that helped me a lot in the beginning is to avoid using the eraser for a while. In this way, you'll be so aware that everything you add will stay put and you'll learn to draw with a light hand and only emphasize the parts that need that. I recommend this technique for both digital and traditional drawings. In fact, I learned this technique by drawing with a ball pen on real paper. Now we'll use lighter colors to add some more details. If you want to learn as much as possible from this tutorial, please stop the video every now and then and compare my drawing with the reference image. Try to understand the decisions that I made so you can adapt them to future projects. For example, I used cooler colors for the feathers and warmer and brighter colors for the beak and legs to have more contrast in the illustration. I also decided to make the beak a little bit longer and more curved because I thought it will balance the composition better. I hope you understand what I'm saying here. You don't need to copy an image by heart. Just take the information that you need from it. You need to start thinking as an artist, keep the things you like from a reference image and change the ones you want to. In a previous video, I was telling you about adapting traditional art techniques to digital art. That's exactly what I did here. So, with that in mind, you can absolutely recreate this drawing with real pastels on paper. I really like how this beak turned out. I think it looks more alive than the original one. When creating a drawing, you really want to have a focal point. In this case, that would be the beak and the eye. Your focal point of the drawing will be that area in the composition to which the viewer's eye is naturally drawn. It's usually the one that has more contrast, maybe brighter colors, and definitely more details than the rest of the drawing. An illustration or painting without a focal point looks flat and simply just not as appealing to the eye. Thank you. Keeping that in mind, I'm just gonna add a few details on the legs and move on to the feathers. Natural feathers, or hairs, don't have such a defined contour, so I want to work on that. First, you want to turn off the alpha lock. Then, use the smudge tool with the drying brush, doing small strokes from the inside to the outside of the contour. Make sure your brush size is quite low. By the way, dry ink is one of the best Procreate brushes for painting. I don't know why I'm not using it more often. This is such an easy thing to do, but it makes such a huge difference for the illustration. To be honest, the smudge tool is really growing on me lately, and I want to play with it some more to find new ways to use it. Let me show you something. It's really important to make the strokes from the inside to the outside. Otherwise, it doesn't look good. Now I'll select the other layers and do the same. When you're done, alpha lock the layers again. Go to the brush library and choose the peppermint brush. This is a pencil brush, you'll find it in the sketching section. Use it to add tiny little white strokes to mimic the feathers in the bird plumage. The more random you draw them, the better they will look, so don't try to be precise. Just use a delicate hand and don't push too hard the pencil on the screen. Adding these kind of details with a thin white pencil is a trick that drawing artists have always used in their work, especially when doing the hair or wrinkles on a portrait. It works just the same with real pencils over a traditional painting. In Procreate, you can use any brush in the sketching section, even the dry brush at a small size. My brushes are also very good for this step, but I really wanted to use a brush that you all have. I zoomed some more so you can see exactly what I'm doing. When drawing, try to think about the direction real feather would have. You can take a look on the reference photo to see that. Speaking of the photo, if you take a good look at it, you will notice that the feathers are not visible on the entire plumage. You can only see them here and there, and that's exactly how we're gonna draw them. I add most of the tiny strokes near the contour, and then some more scattered around the body, neck, and head. To make the bird look even better, I'm using the same brush with a gray color to draw some thin shadows in the plumage. If you want to get the best results when working on the body, it's important to think of the direction of the feathers just as we did before. Again, you'll find all the answers that you need in the reference photo. Now, I'll use the same peppermint pencil brush to add some soft shadows that will complete the drawing. I'm not changing the size of the brush, I have just tilted the pencil a little more. All of the Procreate pencils do that, they leave different traces on the screen depending on the pressure you apply and their inclination, just like a real pencil would perform. Thank you so much if you had the patience to watch this tutorial till the end. I really like how this illustration turned out, and it was a pleasure to draw it for you. Please subscribe to my channel if you want to see more detailed videos like this one. Like this video, that would help me a lot with the YouTube algorithm, and turn on the notification button to make sure you won't miss any new video. Thanks a lot everyone, see you soon with a new tutorial!